So today we are going to discuss about weighted average method, which is considered to be the most accurate of all the four methods. The reason here is in this method we consider the quantity also along with the price of the material. So here we are giving weights. Now what are these weights? Weights are based on the quantity supplied or the quantity of that material in your stock. So every time quantity of material is compared with the stock, with the stock price when you compute the actual amount. So that is why I have put here, price is calculated by dividing total cost of material in stock from which the material to be priced could be drawn by total quantity of material in that stock. So price always will be total cost of material would be considered with the quantity. So the formula for weighted average price method, it's very simple. Only one more thing which you have to add with simple average method is you have to go with the quantity also. So weighted average price is equal to total cost of material divided by total units in stock. Earlier in simple average method, we were just finding the average of prices. But here we are going to take the total aspect, the total concept. That is total cost of the material divided by total quantity, that are total units in stock, which will give us the rate at which the material to be issued. So that is why this method, when we consider, especially with simple average method, it is little more representative of the actual position. That's why we say that if given no choice, no, if the method to be chosen is in your court, you can go with weighted average method, which gives you a little more clear idea about what should be the pricing of this particular material. Now I will show you, it is very simple to understand here. The same exercise which we use for simple average method, the same thing which you are going with the weighted average method. Now the answer will look like this. You can look here. In this case, as we know, now you know the question. We had 600 rupees as opening balance on March 1st for 4 rupees. There is no difference in that. We put that like that itself, 600 for 2400. Then, as you know, we had a receipt. We received 400 units at the rate of 5. Right. So when we receive 400 units at the rate of 5, it will be a receipt which we had put 405,000. Now here what we will do is, here we are going to find out 1,000. Okay, 1,000. And can somebody tell me how did we get this ratio of 4.40? Can someone from the class explain? Its answer is there in the question. Okay, fine. I will tell you. See, it is 4,400. The total quantity when you consider as on that day is 2,000 plus 2,000. 2,000 plus 2,400. You already had 2,400 in your hand as your opening balance. Then you got another 2,000. So the total quantity as on that date, the total amount as on date will be 4,400. Total amount. Accurate total amount. So 2400 is the total opening balance, plus you received another 2000. So 2000 plus 2400, the total value of stock in your hand is 4400. And the total quantity, as you know, will be opening balance of 600 plus the quantity which you received, that is 400. So 1000, right? So as on their date, when you put the rate, it would be 1,000 at the rate of 4.40. Now, how did I get 4.40? It was just dividing the total amount divided by total quantity. So the total amount is nothing but there are two ways with which you can find it out. I'll say the easiest one first, then I will tell otherwise how can you do it. Okay, I'll tell you that. But first, you just have to take the total amount on opening balance. One is 2,400 plus 2,000. So the total amount would be 4,400. You can check at the bottom. The answer is put at the bottom. So 4,400 and the total quantity would be 1,000 because we initially had 600 units as our opening balance. Then we received another 400. So the total quantity would be 1,000. So 4,400 by 1,000 will give you 4.40 as your rate, which we put here. Okay, that is first method. Both are same, but I'm just saying another method to verify it. It's nothing but it will be like this: 600 into 4 plus 400 into 5 divided by 600 plus 200, 600 plus 400. I repeat, this amount 4,400, you can also find it as 600 into 4, quantity into rate. Okay, 600 into 4 plus another quantity into rate, 400 into 5. Okay, 600 into 4 is 2,400. 400 into 5 is 2,000. So automatically the total of that which you will get is 4,400. Instead of doing so much of calculation, we can just do take the amount total, that is 2,400 plus 2,000. That's what I showed you at the beginning. Then divided by the total quantity. That there is no difficulty because we know the total quantity is 600 plus 400, that is 1,000. That's how we got the rate here. Okay, we got the rate here. Then that's as on March 6th, that's our balance, that is 1,000. 4.40, 4,400. We put the rate here, not like simple average. Here we can put the rate because we know that it's not going to change. Okay, now, then the next transaction, which is for us, is an issue on March 8th, issued 300 units. Now for us, it is really clear at what rate we have to go with the issue because we have already computed that. So 300, the rate applicable here is 4.40, which gives you 1,320. 1,320. Now, what you do is here, what you do is you will find out, you can do in two ways, as I said, no, either 4,400 minus 1,320, or you can do as the balance stock, 700 into 4.40. You will get the balance amount as 3,080 on the same day, that is the day of issue, that is on March 8th. Okay, so I repeat here, in weighted average method, how do we do is we find the total amount first, the total amount or cost of your inventory in stock. Inventory in stock divided by total quantity. So total amount is nothing but your number of units into rate. So in this case, I can take this 2,400. How do I get it? It's just the total quantity into rate, 600 into 4. Same way I have in my stock 400 units at the rate of 5. So the total cost of total cost of my inventory would be 600 into 4 plus 400 into 5. It is same as when I take the total of this amount column. So that's how I found out this rate of 4.40 when that amount is divided by total quantity I have. Now I'm going to explain the next one also. Okay. The next one is receive 200 units at the rate of 6. So that is a receipt. Now, how do I do? I put 200 quantity, the rate is 6. So I know it is 1,200. So what do I do? Now I know there is another rate which is applicable to me. Now, how much is my rate? There are two methods with which I can do. I'm going with the simplest method where it is 3,080 plus 1,200. Which gives me 4,280. Both methods are same, okay? Both says the same. One is little lengthy calculation, other one is the shortcut, okay? So I take the total amount, which is 3,080 plus 1,200, which gives me 4,280 as my total amount of, or total cost of inventory, because I receive another 200 unit. Now I know what is my quantity, because on that day, on the previous day, I had a balance of 700 quantity in units, and then I received 200 units more. So the total which I will be putting here is 900, right? 700 after issue of 300 plus the new receipt of 200. So my total quantity will be 900. Now I got the rate. How? My total amount divided by total quantity, that is 4280 divided by 900, which gives me 4.75 as my rate for my new issue. So what I do is, on that day I put the balance as 900, 4.75 as my rate, and of course the amount, we know it, right? Either we can calculate it or we can just add this 3080 plus 1200, which gives me 4280. Right, now going with my last transaction, that is on March 30th, it would be issued to 50 units. Right, so when I'm going in with an issue, I know here in this case what will be my rate, because I've already computed my rate. So my rate here is 250 at the rate of 4.75, which I already calculated, which gives me 1187.5. Now the balance, as I said, I can do in two ways, but I go with the simplest way, that is 4280 minus this amount, which gives me 3092.50. So this is actually a weighted average method where we consider the quantity as well as the cost of inventory, the total amount blocked or invested in inventory when I'm going with my price at which it needs to be issued. So this is weighted average method.